intended to strike the former Soviet Union. But Vietnam and Desert Storm, however, saw the versatility of using the KC-135 to refuel fighters and even cargo aircraft, like the C-17 we have on the ramp behind us from March Airfield. As you may have guessed, coming from the Cold War, these aircraft are not new. They first flew in 1957, and the aircraft flying before you today, I'm told, was first flew in 1959. With the boom extended, the boom operator in the back flying that boom around using those small fins on the boom. Pilots will come in and park into position using a lighting system on the belly. They park off the aircraft, let the boom operator actually do the work to get plugged for the refueling. Over 700 KC-135s were built, serving at the Air Force in Chile, France, Singapore, and Turkey, but of course, the Air Force, by far, the biggest operator with almost 400 of them still in service. Years back, if you started refueling that aircraft, it would take you 49 hours to refuel it. I don't want to be paying the bill on that one. I know you don't either. A little over 2 days to fill that beast up. In addition to the fuel load, the KC-135 can be used for cargo operations as well as passenger movements. Many Beale airmen here today, our air boss, Ralph Royce. Two pilots, co-pilot, and the aircraft commander setting up for what the right base here to runway 15. Call it runway 15 because the magnetic direction of the runway is 150, basically southeast. Or 33 if you're heading northwest. That's where they get the numbers 330 on the mag compass. 135's rolling out on final and slowing down to an approach speed of around 160 miles per hour.